Hello there, my fishy friends. My name is Peter, and today I'm going to take you along on a swim with some salmon under a logjam. I have visited this logjam many times during the salmon season, and it always amazes me just how many salmon fit under there. They find it a safe and sheltered spot, so they rest there during the day, and then they move on under the cover of darkness. The little fish are coho smolts. Coho smolts spend about 2 years in the river, so 1 to 2 years, I guess. And here I'm going to show you something that's kind of a dirty little secret among those who twitch jigs. Twitching jigs always results in foul-hooked fish. I don't care how good you are. If you're twitching jigs when there are a lot of fish around, you're always going to get some foul-hooked ones. So there's a big coho with a jig stuck in its tail. Next to it, there's a chum salmon also with a jig stuck in its tail. It happens. I mean, I twitch jigs too. I'm not bashing anybody. All I'm saying is when you are getting a lot of foul-hooked fish, you really should switch up your technique and pick something different. That's going to be a little better for the fish. Here you see some big Chinook salmon and some chum salmon swimming right alongside with these coho. I've witnessed very little, if any, aggression among these fish. There's kind of a myth among anglers that the chum and the springs are kind of mean to the coho and chase them, but I have never seen any of that. I think where that comes from is that when these fish start spawning, they do turn quite aggressive, but while they're migrating up the river, I have not witnessed any bullying among them. So here I'm going to do something a little bit foolhardy. I'm going to squeeze myself underneath all those branches to try and help out that chum salmon with the jig in its tail. These salmon were pretty calm about my presence, so I figured, well, why not give it a try? And I'm kind of sneaking up behind him, trying to get close enough. The coho in the way. There we go, closer and closer. And success! I got it. Right off the fish. I have to extricate myself from all these logs and fish and sticks. Good thing I have a long breath hold. I really came here to film this beaver. He comes out every night at sunset, but tonight wasn't my night. I didn't get any good shots of him. It's funny, he swam right up to me when my camera wasn't rolling, but then as soon as I turned it on, he was all shy and hiding among the logs, and I never did get a decent shot of him. Nothing worthy of a standalone video anyway, but yeah, they're a cute critter and I find them just as interesting as the fish. And there he goes. Bye bye, Mr. Beaver. So now I'm going to go for a swim underneath the log jam. And I know a couple of people have commented about, you know, staying safe and all that. Trust me, I have a long breath hold. And even if I were to get stuck underneath something here, I'd have plenty of air reserve to get myself out of trouble. I don't know. I've always enjoyed swim throughs for free diving. Swim-throughs are swims through a passage of some sort, and it's pretty neat to be underneath with all these fish. They move out of my way a little bit, but you can see they're not terribly freaked out. I love fishing for coho, but I love swimming with them just as much. Here's one kind of interesting behavior that I've observed on some occasions, is coho will squeeze themselves into holes in the wood. Pretty neat. They're acting like catfish. Now on the way down, I was swimming a bit faster because I was going with the current, and yeah, that did spook the fish a bit. They are a schooling creature, and once one of them spooks, they all seem to kind of dart about and go a little bit crazy. If you want to get a keyboard out and bash me for harassing these fish, well, go right ahead. You're probably right in this case. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time.